Assalamu alaikum. Good morning to everybody. Hi my dear students, how are you? I hope you are doing well. Okay, in this video lesson we are going to see a beautiful poem. A beautiful poem. What is the poem name? You know, Song of a Dream. Okay, Song of a Dream. Those who have the textbook, please take your textbook. Those who don't have the textbook, listen carefully. Okay. Before that, I want to ask you one thing. Do you all seeing the video regularly? You must watch the videos regularly. Okay. So this is chapter 5. This is a poem. Okay, it's not a lesson. It's a poem. Song of a Dream by Sarojini Naidu. Okay, Song of a Dream by Sarojini Naidu. Before we are going to see that poem, we should know about the author. Okay, so for you it's very, very important, because they often ask you about the write about a short profile about the author. So it's very important to study about the author. So Sarojini Naidu, 13th February 1979, 2nd March 1949, also known as the Nightingale of India. So Sarojini Naidu is a Nightingale of India. She is a famous poet. Okay, not only famous poet, now we can see that. Was an activist of the freedom movement in India. Okay, was an activist of the freedom movement in India. Her major contributions in the field of poetry were beautiful poems that could also be sung. So she wrote many poems. Okay, her famous works include The Golden Threshold, The Bird of Time, The Broken Wing and The Sceptred Flute. These all her works. Okay, so she we call her as the Nightingale of India. So before starting the poem, they given some hints. Okay, what is about the poem? Okay, a flower cannot blossom without sunshine. Is it true? No. So a flower cannot blossom without the sunshine. A man cannot live without love. A man cannot live without love. What do you mean by love? Affection and kind to fellow beings. Okay. So in this poem we are going to study about love, peace and truth. Okay. You have to imagine. Okay, we are all going to travel in that forest. Okay, are you all ready? Okay, so is it possible to have a world where we can always enjoy the warmth of love, peace and truth? So the poet was asking, Sarojini Naidu, the poet was asking, shall we see that? We can see the love, peace and truth. Can we see the love, peace and truth in this world? No, never. We cannot see that. So there is lots of fighting is there, war is there. There is no peace at all in our world. So she is asking, we can always enjoy the warmth of love, peace and truth? There is a question mark. She is asking, will it remain as our dream? So she is telling, it's a dream only. We can imagine only. It will not come true. Will it remain as a dream? She is asking. And then, in this poem, Sarojini Naidu, popularly known as the Nightingale of India, takes us to a magical wood. So we are also going to travel in that forest. Okay, what she is dreaming. Okay, she takes us to a magical wood. What do you mean by wood? Wood means forest. Okay, wood, wood. Okay, we meet the angels of love, peace and truth. So now we are going to see the angels of love, angels of peace and angels of truth. Okay, so in your textbook they are beautifully given that this is the angels. Okay, in a forest we are going to see the angels of love, angels of peace, angels of truth. Okay, and then so the poet dreams of being in a magical wood. So the poet was dreaming, it's not really happening, she was dreaming the world would be like that. Okay, the poet was the poet dreams of being in a magical wood. So she was dreaming as if she was in the forest, magical forest, not a normal forest, magical forest. The poet feels the stars of the spirits of love gather and gleam around her. So the poet was feeling, okay, the stars of the spirits of love. Okay, spirits means it's an angel. Okay, spirit means it's an angel. So the poet feels the stars of the spirits of love gather. Gather means it's in a group. They are gather and gleam around her and giving some shining. Okay, gleam around her. Okay, who is that? The stars of the spirits of love. Okay, stars of the spirits of love. It's angel. Okay, angels of love are gather and around us. She hears the songs of the spirits of love. So not only it's gather, but also she can hear the songs of the spirits of love. Okay, and then she bends low by the streams of the spirits of peace to quench her longings. So now she was bending. Bending means lowering like that. Bending by the streams of spirits of peace. Okay. So there is a river is there. She is going to drink the water. Okay. She is going to drink the water. And then so first one she was seeing the spirits of love. Second one is spirits of peace as a river. Okay, spirits of peace as a river. So here one meaning they have given, quench. Quench means satisfy. By drinking. Understand? So thirsty, feeling thirsty. Okay? So the beautiful poem of Sarojini Naidu is about a dream of her. Okay, so she bends lower to drink the water. So to satisfy is quench. Okay? Thirsty. The beautiful poem of Sarojini Naidu is about a dream of her. The poetess in her dream happen. So, if the author is a woman, you have to mention as poetess. Okay. The author is a woman means you have to mention as poetess. Don't say poet. So the poetess in her dream happened to stand in the light of a magical wood. So in a forest she was standing. So it's a full of lights. Okay, full of lights, and she was standing middle of the forest, magical wood. The spirits of truth appear to her as birds that song. So now the first one is spirits of truth. What do you mean by truth? Truth means always telling truth, not telling lies. Okay, so now the angels of truth appeared as a bird. Okay, appeared to her as bird. So the spirits of truth appeared to her as birds. Understand? That birds also singing. Okay, the spirits of truth also singing. The spirits of love came to her as stars. So the spirits of love means what? Affection, kind to the fellow beings. Okay, those spirits of love came to her as the stars. Okay, as the stars that glowed means shining. The stars are shining. Understand? And then next one, the spirits of peace flowed her as streams. Already I mentioned that. Okay, so the spirits of peace flowed her as a stream. Streams means river. The poetess felt the stars of the spirits of love gather around her. So the spirits of love, the spirits of love as a star. Okay, the spirits of love appeared as a stars and gather around her. She could hear the songs of the spirits of truth also. Okay, so the poem is very simple. So what is that? The poetess was dreaming as if she is in the magical forest, and she was seeing the spirits of truth, spirits of love, spirits of peace. Okay, and then and she was enjoying in that forest. Okay, so now I will read out the poem, then you can understand that. Once in the dream of a night, I stood alone in the light of a magical wood. So in a dream, I was standing alone in the light of a magical wood, magical moods in a forest. Soul deep in visions that poppy like sprung. There is one word they given. Poppy means a plant with a large, delicious red flower. Understand? It's a flower. So a visual images of flower also coming in her dream. Okay, visual images of flowers also coming in her dream. And spirits of truth were the birds that sing. So the angels of truth were the birds. Okay, the angels of truth were the birds that also singing. And then the spirits of love, the angels of love were the stars. Understand? The angels of love were the stars that glowed means shining. Glowed means shining. And then the spirits of peace. Peace means what? Tranquility. Peace means tranquility. And then, the spirits of peace were the streams. So the angels of peace as a river, flowing like a river. In that magical wood, in the land of sleep, lone in the light of that magical grove. Grove means in a small group of trees. Okay, grove means in a small group of trees. She was standing in between the small trees. I felt the stars of the spirits of love gather and gleam around my delicate youth. So the spirits of love or the angels of love are gather and shining. Okay, and shining gleam around my delicate youth. They are also surrounded by her. I heard the song of the spirits of truth. She can hear the song of the spirits of angels of truth. To quench my longing, I bend me low by the dreams of the streams of the spirits of peace that flow in that magical wood in the land of sleep. Okay, so the main point is what is that? The poetess was in the forest. She was seeing the angels of truth. She was seeing the angels of love. She was seeing the angels of peace. Okay. And then this angels of truth is as a bird. She was seeing as a bird. And then the spirits of love, she was seeing as the stars. And then the spirits of peace, she was seeing as a river. Understand? So this is the very simple poem. So all should read the textbook. You can enjoy the poem. Once more, I read out the poem. Just you listen. Once in the dream of a night, I stood lone in the light of a magical wood. Soul deep in visions that poppy light sprang, and spirits of truth were the birds that sang. And spirits of love were the stars that glowed. And spirits of peace were the streams that flowed. In that magical wood in the land of sleep, lone in the light of that magical grove, I felt the stars of the spirits of love gather and gleam round my delicate youth. And I heard the songs of the spirits of truth, and to quench my longing, I bed me low by the streams of the spirits of peace that flow in that magical wood in the land of sleep. So it's a very, very beautiful poem. So here the poetess was using imagery. Imagery means the poet is giving a clear picture of a magical wood using words such as pictures in their mind, the language that makes people imagine picture in their mind. So the poetess was creating imagination. Okay, we can form a picture, that we called it as a imagery. Okay, imagery. So the poet is using the imagery in that poem. So this is a beautiful poem. All of you read the textbook, enjoy the poem by reading the stanza. Understand? So I will see you in next class in a new chapter. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you.